Hello friends, welcome to my channel Mirror of Psychology. Please subscribe this channel for more psychology related information. In today's video, we are going to talk about the past theory of intelligence. The past theory of intelligence was proposed by educational psychologist Jagannath Prasad Das, Jack A. Nagliery and Kirby. It's a cognitive model that offers a unique way of understanding intelligence by focusing on the brain's cognitive processes rather than just IQ scores or general intelligence and specific abilities. The word past stands for four key cognitive functions, and they are planning, attention, simultaneous processing, and successive processing. Let's break these down one by one. Planning is all about setting goals, creating strategies to achieve them, and evaluating how well those strategies work. This involves higher-level thinking like problem-solving and decision-making. For example, when you are solving a difficult math problem, you plan your steps, adjust your approach, and keep a track of your progress to find the right answer. Attention is the ability to focus on specific information while ignoring distractions. It's what allows you to stay concentrated on one task for a period of time. Imagine you are in a noisy classroom but can still focus on the teacher's lecture, so that's attention at work. Simultaneous processing is about putting together multiple pieces of information to understand their patterns or relationships. For instance, when you look at a map or solve a puzzle, you are using simultaneous processing to see how different parts fit together to form a whole picture. So simultaneous processing is used to integrate the different parts into a whole or the complete picture. Successive processing is the ability to organize information in a specific order, like following steps or recalling items in a sequence. For example, if a student is given the words like this, and then they are asked to recall them exactly in this sequence later, so the student is using successive processing to memorize and recall the words in a specific sequence rather than as a random collection. The past theory is based on the work of Russian neuropsychologist Alexander Luria, who identified three functional units in the brain that are crucial for different types of cognitive activities. The first functional unit includes the brain stem and structures like the reticular activating system, which controls attention and arousal. So this unit supports the attention component of the past theory. The second unit includes the occipital, parietal, and temporal lobes in the back of the brain. This unit is responsible for receiving, analyzing, and storing sensory information, which supports both simultaneous and successive processing of the past theory. The third functional unit is located in the frontal lobes at the front of the brain and is responsible for higher-order thinking like planning and decision-making. So this unit supports the planning component of the past theory. The past theory is used in the cognitive assessment system, which is a type of psychological assessment to evaluate intelligence based on these four components. It's particularly useful in identifying cognitive strengths and weaknesses in children and in guiding interventions for learning disability, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, and other cognitive challenges. Unlike traditional IQ tests, which focus on a single score, past theory gives a more detailed picture of how someone processes information. Thanks for watching the video. If you found this video helpful, then don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.